It's scientific nonsense. There's no evidence to support it at all.
A central Alberta business says they're banning anyone who has had the COVID-19 vaccine in the last 4 weeks from entering their store because of the risk, they claim, of so-called shedding. Scientific experts say this is the latest in misinformation surrounding vaccines, that after getting a dose, you shed modified cells, kind of like a cat sheds their fur, and then that gets on other people.
It's not supported in science. It's conceptually incoherent. And I think it's a very dangerous message.
Professor Timothy Caulfield says these conspiracy theories are being used to drive vaccine hesitancy. The business who posted this sign claiming it's to protect a pregnant employee and at the advice of medical professionals and their insurance provider, but did not answer City News's request for comment or say what insurance provider. But the owner wrote on Facebook, they're waiting for more scientific evidence.
Because you'll often have people say, oh, well, there's no evidence. So, well, that maybe means if they did study, they'd find it. It's not even scientifically plausible.
Saying it would be expensive and a waste of time to study what has no scientific backing. It's the type of misinformation Caulfield is hoping to counter with science up first, where credible experts take to social media, where misinformation breeds, to break down what's backed by scientific proof and what's not, and how to verify your sources.
The way that this kind of misinformation can have a really big impact is just causing people to start to question things, to doubt things. And that little bit of doubt can have a real big impact on intention to vaccinate, which is really problematic. So I think it's really important to counter this misinformation as soon as it emerges.
Mm-hmm. But be more concerned about your cat shedding than your vaccinated loved one.
That's right. Watch for that dander. Don't worry about the vaccine shedding.
For more on spotting the signs of misinformation and the scientific process, you can find our full interview with Professor Caulfield on our YouTube page. In Edmonton, Carly Robinson, City News.